Hey there, welcome back to yet another episode in the journey of demystifying the Patents Act. In this episode, we will discuss yet another topic that many of you are looking for, the PCT applications, both the national phase as well as the international phase. But before we go ahead and discuss the requirements and the procedures associated with the PCT applications, let's do a quick recap by going over this video. There could be a scenario where you may require additional time on hand before you make an assessment, before you make a judgment that you would want to enter in other countries also. So for that, we have another treaty known as Patent Cooperation Treaty. Now, what does it do is it provides you another option to extend your timelines or to enter Indian Patent Office that way. So as per the illustration, you can file an international application, a PCT application, either directly. This is known as international application. It can be filed with the main office, PCT, IB, Geneva, or it can be filed with other countries who can act as the receiving office. We don't need to worry about it. We will discuss it in subsequent videos. For the timing, let's focus on the filings. So the entire timeline that we have is 31 months from the very first filing. So the two roads that you see there where first time I filed with a convention country, then I filed with the PCT within 12 months, and then I entered India within 31 months from the first filing. Second route could be the first filing itself was with PCT, the international application. From there again, I entered with Indian Patent Office. Overall time remains as 31 months. Again, the forms remain the same, the requirements remain the same from the Indian Patent Office point of view. Now, with this background, we know that a PCT application can be filed either directly with IB or through the contracting states acting as the receiving office. As you file the PCT application, you are required to designate countries. Now, these are the countries where you seek to protect your invention. By default, all the countries are designated, but then also if you wish to remove some, you can do so. As you continue the filing process, you are required to select an International Searching Authority, ISA. Now, this is one of the patent offices that would be conducting prior art search for your invention to give you some clue with respect to the patentability of your invention. The report that gets created by ISA is called International Search Report, ISR. What could be the example of such offices? The standard ones, USPTO, EPO, Chinese Patent Office, Indian Patent Office, Australian Patent Office, and Austrian Patent Office. Moving on, you're also provided with an option of selecting an International Preliminary Examining Authority, IPEA. Again, this is a patent office that you can interact with to discuss the ISR, to make amendments, to make changes to your claim, to obtain a favorable report for your invention. Now, this is an optional stage. It's up to you whether you want to avail this service or not. Let's move forward and discuss the timelines associated with these activities. As discussed, a PCT application can be filed with or without claiming priority. In case a priority is claimed, the PCT application needs to be filed within 12 months from the earliest priority date. Now, once the application is filed, ISA is selected, and ISA has received the search copy, ISA comes out with a report, the ISR, preferably within 16 months from the priority date. At this stage, the applicant can either ignore the report or can make changes to the claims to overcome any negative remarks that would have been put in the ISR. Now, once this stage is completed, the application is published and it is called international publication. The ISR also gets published along with the application. Now, this is the time when the applicants decide whether he wishes to file the demand for examination through one of the IPEAs. This has to be done within 22 months from the earliest priority date. From here on, the activities pertaining to the filing of national phase application starts. Now, as per the options available with us, we have two sets of countries. One that provides 30-31 month of time frame for enabling the applicant to enter the national phase in their countries, and another which provides a shortened time frame of 20 months for entering the national phase application in their countries. In case the applicant is not filing for demand of examination through one of the IPAs, then the applicant needs to file the national phase application through Chapter 1 filing so as to meet the requirement of either 20 months deadline or 30-31 months deadline as per the respective countries. In case of Chapter 1 filing, the ISRs and the written opinion as generated by the ISAs are converted to patentability report, which can then be used by the member countries as they evaluate the invention once the invention has entered the national phase in their countries. It's not binding though, it's up to them whether they want to use it or not. In case of Chapter 2, where the applicant has demanded for examination through one of the IPA, in such case, the applicant can interact with the patent office, the chosen patent office, to either make amendments to get a favorable report, which can then be passed on to the member countries as the application enters the national phase. So with this, national phase application needs to be completed within 20 months or 30-31 months based on the countries that you are looking at. A tiny homework for you at this stage. Can you identify any countries that only provide you 20 months for entering the national phase application in their country? Okay, so time for us to view this process from the perspective of Indian Patent Office. Starting with the international application, when the Indian Patent Office acts as the receiving office. So most of the information remain the same. A few information that you need to keep in mind. So Delhi is considered as the head office for interacting with IB, ISA and IPEA. Also, as you are filing the application with the Indian Patent Office as the receiving office, the appropriate office would be same as we discussed under Rule 4, based on the place of business, domicile or service address. So once the receiving office receives the application, it keeps one copy for itself, transfers a record copy to IB, and transfers a search copy to the ISA. Now, one important thing to keep in mind, if you are an Indian resident and if you are filing for a PCT international application, you cannot and you should not file a PCT application directly with IB or with Indian Patent Office as receiving office without obtaining FFL or without accompanying the application with the FFL request, even with the Indian Patent Office being the receiving office. Keep in mind. Now let's move on and learn the functionalities of Indian Patent Office as ISA. In India, Delhi Patent Office acts as the ISA. Now for conducting the examination of the application, an examiner is appointed who is required to prepare the report, ISR, either within 3 months from the receipt of the search copy or within 9 months from the priority date of the application. The usual examination process happens. There can be scenario where ISR may not be issued or generated. Could be because of the subject matter which does not require any search or cannot be searched. Or there could be issue with respect to the compliance where the documents are not submitted or documents are not in proper format as per the requirements. In such cases, ISR may not be generated. Similarly, in case of unity of inventions, the patent office may only provide ISR for a main invention and may demand additional fee for the other set of claims which are not considered as part of the main invention. Here also a protest or hearing route is provided to the applicant to navigate through the situation. So once the report is generated, the ISR is forwarded to IB as well as to the applicant. Let's move to the next slide, where Delhi Patent Office can also act as IPER. Here also, an examiner is appointed to carry out the examination. As per the usual examination process, an examination report is generated, which is then shared with IB as well as the applicant. So this was about international application where India acts as the receiving office or searching authority or the receiving office. What about the process of national phase application in India? We have gone through this slide multiple times. So the important things to note are the national phase application needs to be completed within 31 months from the priority date. The forms to be used are Form 1, 2, 3, 5, and 26. Here are a few specific points that you may want to remember. While entering the national phase application in India, an applicant can delete claims from the PCT application. From the document's point of view, English translation of all documents should be provided. Similarly, priority documents also should be submitted within due time frame. Once the application is filed, the application is not processed before the expiry of 31 months from the priority date. However, in case you wish to opt for an express prosecution, you can do so using Form 18. Also, selection of IPO as ISA or IPEA can help you expedite your prosecution. So with this, we have learned various aspects of PCT applications. So can you think of any benefits or advantages that you can derive from a PCT application? Let's have a look at it. So from an applicant's point of view, by filing a PCT application, you are buying extra time, which you can use to evaluate the product, evaluate the invention, evaluate the market itself. And you can also evaluate the success rate of your patent, whether you would get a patent or not. Accordingly, you can take an informed decision with regards to what all countries you wish to file your application in. You can save time and efforts. Now, from the patent office's point of view, because PCT provides you with ISRs, written opinions, and patentability reports, such reports, even though not binding, can help the patent offices to reduce their burden. And from the society's point of view, because there is an international publication happening, that too in English language, it provides the public or the industry access to wealth of information that would lead to further technical advancement. These are a few points which WIPO itself talks about. Finally, here is the snapshot of the timelines for a PCT application. Another interesting aspect about PCT application is that it can be withdrawn within 30 months from the priority date. So this brings us to the end of this episode. I hope you found it useful. We will meet again as we discuss yet another topic. Till then, be good and take care.